What I like the best is that it kind of feels like home in there. Like, with the bathrooms before, you know, you would go in there and it would kind of feel weird because it was all dark and gloomy, but with these bathrooms, they're like illuminated and they're brighter, they're more open, and you get a sense of security in them. So it kind of feels like you're at home and you don't have many worries in these bathrooms. Before, bathrooms would be on, like, there'd be one in one corner and then you'd have to go all the way to the other side of the school to go to another bathroom, and then it was like gender separated, so it would probably be girls on one corner and then guys all the way on the other side of the school. But now you can go to any corner and go to the bathroom, so there's more opportunities to go.
There's a lot more privacy and you just feel comfortable and you just don't have to worry about like little things that you would have to worry about in a traditional restroom. And it feels much more cleaner than the ones before. I didn't feel like I wanted to use the bathroom, like I would wait to go home.
A traditional bathroom, you know, there's a door and you go in, and then inside the bathroom you have your stalls, your sinks and things like that. What they did with the inclusive bathrooms here is they literally knocked down some of the walls that would create that bathroom so that you have your the vanity area where it's just your sink and your mirrors and your paper towel area. And that space is completely open. It really holds true to that whole open concept idea. Where there's areas where there are pillars or walls, there are glass windows that are put there, so you can see whoever's walking in, whoever's walking out, whoever's, you know, washing their hands and all that stuff. And then as far as the actual toilet area, there are individual stalls and doors go from floor to ceiling. Here in the front, where there's more traffic, there's like five or six stalls. And they are literally right next to each other and they lock, you go in and out. You have the privacy to do what you need to do. When I first came into Johnson here, this was my first experience with inclusive bathrooms. And I wasn't hesitant on it being, oh, all genders are using it, but more so staff and students using it. That was my hesitation of, do I want to be in the same common area doing my private business with the same area as students doing their private business? But honestly, it's a human thing. We all have to do it. And within that 4 minutes, you really just are taking care of your business. And the privatization of each stall really just makes it more comfortable.
We can see the public spaces. You know, traditional bathrooms have a sort of public space and they have a sort of private space, okay? And the public space, you know, that inner room that's outside from the hallway, but not in the bathroom stall, toilet stall, that's where the problems were for in-person bullying in a lot of places, lots of times. And so that's gone. It's like you removed it. It's like you went upstream and said that whole possibility for that kind of interaction is now in a public space, and people, bullies don't do that in public spaces. So that removes that whole problem.
When we first realized that we were going to look at an inclusion model within the Johnson School, our first stop, essentially after working through with the architects that this was a possibility, was the students. We sat down and we formed focus groups with the students to understand how they felt about it, how they felt about the old restroom, how we could better the old restroom, and then that morphed into what the new restroom could look like. We overlaid that too with staff conversations, community conversations, and internally we were still behind the scenes working with all those same agencies, our designers, the city. We even approached the state. So a lot of that was happening in parallel. And then we finally got to a point where we felt that we were very comprehensive on all the information that we had, put that model together, approached the students with it, and they were very much on board, became advocates in the design itself. And then we just fine-tuned it a little bit so it best fit within the Johnson School footprint, and it went into the design and now they've been built.
When we're trying to create welcoming and affirming environments for all people, there are often designs that are outside of the box, outside of the paradigms of how things have been done, that when we can step back and listen to people from different perspectives, we can invite ideas that radically change the experience of day-to-day life for lots of people.
I would say you have inclusive restrooms in your house. And so this is nothing, this is just taking sort of reality and putting it in a public institution.